I'm Chad. I'm a second year student here at DCTC. I've been an apprentice at Abra in Bloomington for just about a year now. Doing some frame damage here, repair on a 2005 Ford Focus. three door. Got hit here, and this here was the main impact. We've already cut the reinforcement impact bar off. Right now we're going to be pulling out this frame here to get it straight, and then using the three-dimensional measurement system to make sure that everything else is in line where it should be.
I'm Jerry Rainford. I'm the second year instructor here at Dakota County Technical College. Chad's a typical second year student where we get into different levels of repair needs, from just simple door repair to what you can see here is a full unibody reconstruction. Mechanical aspects as well, getting into the air conditioning and other mechanical systems on the vehicle, suspension, driveline. This is kind of the way that once we have the vehicle anchored on our frame rack, we come through and we can actually do a pull on it. We're going to be doing a light pull this morning on the unibody structure. We're going to see if we can't repair the rails. Typically when they're kinked to this point, we would do a replacement procedure, but we're going to see if we can't repair them today. So we'll just kind of talk as we go through it, and we'll see if we can get the rails to come out. So Chad, please take over from here.
All right. I'm going to be using these towers here that are capable of pulling 10,000 pounds a piece to try to get this mash come out on this left frame rail here.
So once again, keep pulling. We're going to be pulling at a constant level that's going to be straight out to try to replace the height, length, and width of the rail. So we're going to keep the direction straight and at a straight pulling distance.
And all I'm doing here now is just watching as I'm pulling, going slowly to find out how the metal is going to react. Everything reacts different, not any accident is the same. Everything needs to be taken out with a different viewpoint. What I'm going to do now is just hit this metal here to try to relieve some of this stress. And always while you're pulling, what you're going to want to do is check your anchoring points again to make sure that the car is not going anywhere. Make sure all your chains and clamps are still tight. As you notice, I'm staying above or not standing behind these chains just in case anything would happen to let go.
Side of the rail through here a little bit as well. Target. One of the things we don't want to do is we don't want to do additional damage as we're pulling. Now it looks like we're pulling more from the bottom of the rail than we are from the top. So at this point in time, I think we should stop, rehook, and grab a hold of the top of the clamps more to pull more on the top of this rail.
Both these dozers here are run by the same pump, so as I pull, it's going to pull them equally.
Okay, let's get some pressure on there.
Just trying to relieve this stress, move the metal where I want it.
So let's get a couple of hits with this on the back side. Right now we're concerned with over pulling on it, and so I think we're gonna stop and we're gonna re-grab onto the rail in a different location. Once you over pull it and it distorts the rail, then we've got an issue.
We're gonna cut this outside of this rail here off, this cap. Just a piece of sheet steel here out of high strength steel. We're gonna pull this off here so that way we can get inside here too and make proper welds and get this metal straight again. We're just going to be cutting it along, drill out these spot welds here, and then cut it here at a seam or at a line, section it out.
Why don't you show them how we know how far we need to pull by using the measuring system? System real quick.
Alright. As we pull out on this stuff here to get this rail out to where it should be, these targets here measure with this beam underneath the vehicle, measures the vehicle at all kinds of different points. Four in the middle of the vehicle, two at the rear of the vehicle, and then these here in the front closest to the damage. This vehicle, this chart here for the vehicle is specific for this vehicle. What this does here is it hangs targets from the vehicle at specific manufacturing locations and measures the vehicle throughout there. We can tell that our center section here is good and the back of the vehicle is good, but up here we're dealing with off measurements on the front end from the impact.
We're going to take, and when we got the rails pulled back into a location by the manufacturer's specifications, we'll hammer and dolly all this straight, and we've got new components, we've got a new reinforcement bar that we will be welding into place to replace the structure of the vehicle. Then we'll come through, replace the, if you want to come around over here, you can see that the radiator condenser has been damaged in this accident, and it's completely, we've lost all the freon. So we'll be doing an R&R procedure on the condenser assembly, and then we're going to evac and recharge your air conditioning system and move forward with the rest of the mechanical repairs at this time. In some situations, when you get composite intake manifolds like this, components can come back and do damage to the intake manifold, starters, alternators, AC compressors. We have additional damage deeper in the vehicle. And this one, we've simply got a condenser to replace. What's the, how long will it take you to do this repair?
This repair here will take me probably about 2 weeks to finish, to complete. Done quite a bit already. I already had all my parts ordered. Those have already been checked in and identified and made sure that they are the right parts. So I'm not scrambling at the end of the project to find the correct parts. I'd say about 2 weeks, two to three weeks would be a good timeline for this vehicle.
Well, thank you, Chad. I appreciate it, taking your time with the students. And this is what we do here at Dakota County Technical College. It's a two-year program. We try to get you ready with the latest technology and the latest equipment to make sure that they're ready for the industry and so they can be productive and profitable in today's unibody reconstruction world. Thanks very much.